Well, howdy. Welcome to the first ever vlog for the One Day in SoCal podcast. Hopefully this will complement the podcast a little bit. I'm hoping to release a vlog for each episode we do, which will be every 2 weeks, first and third Friday of every month. Today I am in downtown Los Angeles, and we are headed for the Los Angeles Convention Center, which is hosting today and all week long the LA Auto Show for 2022. Let's go in and take a look at what's new in the auto industry. Some of you wanted to know what an electric motor looks like. Electric vehicles. That's all there is to it. This is the Halo by Indy One, a new Los Angeles car company that's coming out. Pretty slick. I love the LEDs. And the seemingly endless screens. And I don't know what the VR is for, but interesting. Electromechanica is coming out with the Solo. Basically a one-person electric car. It's like a smart car. It's like something out of Fallout. Personal little car. Can't take your friends or family anywhere. And not your dog either, to the vet. But really, go for it, dude. What are these gonna run?
They run 18.5.
18,500?
Yep.
Not too shabby. Love the design. With the old, in with the new. Talk about supercar. Lots of opportunities to test drive the latest vehicles. Here's one from Ram. See if this guy knows how to drive a little better. Pretty impressive. One of the most popular things to do at the LA Auto Show is test drive vehicles. This test drive obstacle course is from Ram. this is a pretty steep incline here. I don't know if the fisheye effect on the GoPro is gonna affect the video quality or not, as far as how steep this is, but that's a solid 45 degree angle or so. No, I'm not in Yosemite. I am at the Subaru display. I'll tell you, if I wasn't a Tesla guy, I would definitely be a Subaru guy. Probably my second favorite car. Just beautiful, very capable cars that you can use in both city and out in the sticks. All right, headed out of the forest here and off to the beach. I guess we're out of the city now. This is a prototype vehicle, something Subaru is working on. It's an Impreza, though. About to test the towing capacity of this Ram truck here. One thing I do notice is they're using the same truck for each test drive for the towing test. So I don't know if this is their model that can tow the most, or maybe they just want to use the same vehicle for maintenance or something. I'm not sure. But let's watch them hook this up. Hooked up. And according to Ram, they're gonna tow 3,790 pounds here. Correction, 37,090 pounds. 3,000, I don't know where I got that. Impressive.
Electrified vehicles since 2004, so we know a thing or two about electric. And today we're here to show you how different electrified vehicle options work and to help you decide which one could be right for you. Now first, here's a little pop quiz, so grab your phones and scan the QR code to begin. We're gonna play a little game. Who wants to participate?
I'll participate.
Yes! I'm excited.
Well, she got one.
Let's do this.
Other than that, nobody else wants to see Fords.
10 seconds. All right, number one, true or false? A front-wheel drive Ford Maverick Hybrid is able to haul 1,300 pounds of logs.
Well, of course it's gonna be true, because it's impressive.
Let's do a mental lock-in for that answer.
Okay, we gotta stay in
sync. Number two. Ready? With a full charge and a full tank, the Ford Escape plug-in hybrid has enough range to go from here to San Francisco, Ajo, Arizona, Reno, Nevada. That one's kind of tricky. Start calculating those miles right now. Number three, how long does it take to charge an extended battery Mustang Mach-E from 10% to 80% at a DC fast charging station?
I was feeling bad for this lady, but it looks like she's starting to get some customers
hours,
now.
6.5 hours.
Or some potential customers.
All right, time's up. Let's talk electric. Ford offers three types to suit your lifestyle: hybrid, plug-in hybrid, and all electric. Full hybrid vehicles have a gas engine and a battery-powered electric motor. They run on both and can switch the gas for longer distances or harder driving. Hybrids can be a first step into the world of electrified vehicles and are great for those who can't plug in at home or at work. So for question one, the answer is true. With a maximum payload of up to 1,500 pounds, Ford Maverick Hybrid can easily haul 1,300 pounds of logs or lumber. It's pretty great. And with an EPA estimated range of 500 miles, it can get you and your gear wherever you need to go. Ford also offers hybrid versions of Escape, Explorer, and F-150. So this is a hybrid ride for range. Hybrids also have.
Here we are in the Ford section. They have a huge section of the showroom floor. I used to be a very, very big Ford fan. Unfortunately, they lost me. And we'll talk about more about why on the podcast. But here's a quick walkthrough of the Ford section. I will say, I do like their Mavericks. I just like the style. This is one of their newer electric trucks. The Ford Lightning. I think Ford and Ram and Kia and all these companies are going to have to do and understand about making electric vehicles. Something that Tesla figured out from the very beginning is the charging stations. There's a reason why Tesla is number one. It's because I could go absolutely anywhere in a Tesla and you're pretty much limited by these vehicles. And even if you want to go somewhere and you want to use public charging stations, you're stuck with these things, which often don't work or are very slow. Sometimes they take 6, 7, 8 hours to charge your vehicle up. Whereas I can go, let's say I'm going from, you know, Wrightwood to Las Vegas, one, maybe two Tesla stops. Charge up your car 20, 30 minutes and you're going again. So if these companies actually want to get serious about getting into the space, the electric EV vehicle space, and it looks like they all do from what I'm seeing so far, they're going to hash out some kind of nationwide electric vehicle charging network. And you see here where you have to get out, you have to scan something, you have to tap. With Tesla, you just plug it in and go. It figures out what your car is. Your credit card is already on file with Tesla. Here you're gonna have to have an app or scan something or text or X, Y, and Z. I will say that this Electrify America charger here is at least 350 kilowatt hours, which is very fast, similar to Tesla. So if more of them build this, it'll be a lot better, and they'll get a bigger market share. Until then, Tesla's gonna stay number one. just by sheer fact that their vehicles are cost effective as far as buying a new one. And they just have their supercharger network, which lets you go absolutely anywhere across North America, except maybe Alaska. This is kind of a neat little truck. The Ford Ranger. I love the tent setup. I could definitely picture myself adding this if I had a Ford Ranger. You guys know Ford has brought back their Bronco line, and I love the design of these too. Perhaps a Jeep competitor, though I will say I think I like Jeeps a little better, maybe a lot better. It's kind of like a cross between a PT Cruiser and a Jeep, I guess. Still, they look like capable vehicles for sure. I can definitely picture going off-road in something like this Ford Raptor Bronco. So you got yourself a Ford Bronco, huh? A 2023 Ford Bronco. Well, nice, impressive. But don't forget the accessories. Don't forget your Ford Bronco hot pepper red thermos. Your bulletproof vest. Just kidding. I'm actually not sure what that is, but it looks like it goes as part of the seat. Like maybe behind the seat, something to hold. But it's definitely got like a military MOLLE system there.
Get out of the car now. Let's go. Like, do run time.
I will tell you, I've needed one of these for a while, and we'll talk about on the podcast about what happened when I got stuck once, and I thought I was in big trouble. And if you're going to buy the Bronco, you may as well get the jacket and the hat. I would. Just a couple more accessories that you can add to your Ford Bronco. They've really accessoried out the vehicle. There's just so much you can do with it. It's amazing.
Great.
So much you can add to it. I originally said this was kind of a... It's like they were trying to go up against... PT Cruiser and Jeep. It looks like they're trying to go head-to-head with Jeep here. With all the accessories and everything that you can add to it and expand it. Even a JBL speaker system. What's your favorite cup? Thermos or a coffee cup? If you want to go for a test ride, you're going to have to pretend you're at Disneyland for a minute. Because lots of lines and long lines at that to get in.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Here comes the Bronco doing a climb. Let's see what this thing's made of. Truck trailer is designed and set up to have vehicles climb over a ramp. Before they get to that point, they go through the little bumps test over there. That's a vehicle we just saw. Let's check out one more. Here's the latest and greatest from Ford with their Mustang lineup. This is the Mustang Dark Horse, as they call it. It's amazing how long the Mustang line has lasted. That does speak volumes, I think, on the car, or if you prefer, hatchback version.
I can't wait to get from London. I know you can. So what an amazing lineup. Intrigued and as excited as I am. Shine your love and make sure.
We saw the Ram test track earlier. Let's go take a look at some of the vehicles up close now. These vehicles really do shine, don't they? Those of you with a courier business, you're not left out at the auto show. Here's the latest and greatest from Ram. It's called the ProMaster 2500 cargo van. Look at all that space. You know what I would do with this space is turn it into a mini RV. Here's an all-electric Dodge Charger on a turntable. Automakers are going electric. Problem is, are they going to be affordable for the average person? As it stands right now, no. But, you know, not everybody could afford a car back in the day when we started making cars. Not everybody could afford a horse before there were cars. So maybe as the technology continues, they'll get cheaper and cheaper, especially with the competition. I mean, virtually every automaker here has most of their cars are electric. So it's obviously the trend. Will it stick around, or is this just a fad? I don't know. I hope it sticks around. Soccer moms, don't fret. There's something here for you too. Here's a Chevy Pacifica starting at almost $60,000. Ouch. Still very nice. That custom interior. Here we are at the Jeep test track, and absolutely love Jeeps, their capabilities, their history, and let's see what they're made of. Let's see what they're capable of. This is about 55 degree climb. I think it's going to be distorted on the GoPro fisheye lens, but definitely very steep. and I'd be terrified if I was climbing this thing. I'd be too afraid it was going to flip backwards or something. Because I'm not a car guy, I'm not a physics guy, I'm not an engineer. But just look at the raw power of that thing. Let's go on our first test ride. Let's see what's going on over here. For the first time since I've been here, there's a crowd gathering at the Ford display. I think they're gonna unveil this car. Like some kind of Mustang. And there it is.
All right, LA, I like that. You can make some noise. I like that. That's great.
The 2024 Ford Mustang.
We met Mach-E, but now let's meet the newest pony in our stable. And here it is, the all-new 7th generation Ford Mustang, making its world debut this year. So, let's get this baby into my garage and break it down a little bit. What do you say? Turn on the lights. I cleaned up the garage before you all got here, so don't worry. Now, everyone knows that Mustang has been the heart and soul of Ford for generations, but it's also a vehicle.
EVgo fast charging. Fast is in the eye of the beholder, isn't it? Where a Tesla charger might take me 20-30 minutes to get going again. Most of my EVgo chargers I've been to have been more like 6 or 7 hours. So hopefully they're gonna get faster and be a little competitive. Heading into the Porsche section of the auto show now. Let's see what Porsche has in store for us. They're not just showing off cars, they're showing off works of art as well. If you have a chunk of change, that could be you sitting in a Porsche. Classic race cars here, built by Porsche. Okay, this one I don't get. This car doesn't look like it's particularly well suited for off-roading. But it's got a tent on top, a Porsche licensed tent. I'm not sure if you're gonna be going to Moab with this thing. maybe Yosemite. There's enough paved roads. But I think Moab's out for this Porsche here. You guys might remember Porsche and Tesla having a little friendly rivalry where Tesla kept breaking speed records on test tracks. And then Porsche came in and started beating Tesla, and it went a little back and forth. I don't know where we're at now as far as the competition, but beautiful car. I love that display in the center console there as opposed on the dash. I think that's kind of neat. Well, if this thing can't beat a Tesla, this one might. Just the aerodynamics on this thing are just nuts, aren't they? How many sleepless nights were spent engineering this piece of art? Here's a company called 27 North. Looks like they design adventure vehicles. Ford, but look at this camper. It's even got a camera on the outside. For security? Let's check it out, shall we? That looks comfortable. Now, I've always wanted an RV, but I would certainly take this. It's even got a shower. Wow. All right, we've transitioned to the South Hall now. I was getting scared. I thought this might have been everything you've seen so far was the whole auto show, but that's not the case. There's plenty to see still in a whole nother building. There's also some outdoor test drives where you can actually test drive as opposed to have somebody test drive for you. And there's some outdoor displays as well, some outdoor vehicles. I've seen these race trucks before, but I've never actually seen one up close. Look at that. Look at this roll cage. Very simplified, huh? Down to the basics. Toyota is going for Made in America. I like it. I always wish more stuff was made here. Proudly built in Kentucky.
And we want to inspire everyone everywhere to start your impossible.
I'm impressed, Toyota.
She recorded a message.
Hope you build more cars here.
Hello, I'm the Sonic Master. And this is Stanley, my Sienna. I hope you enjoyed visiting the Toyota display today. Toyota encourages everyone to start your impossible. And remember, you don't have to be great to start.
Some of the other vehicles, the Toyota Supra.
Enjoy the auto show, everyone. Also, fun fact, Stanley loves making pretzels. So, cheers!
Cheers! Oksana Masters!
Yeah, she's great. Now, if you want to know what it feels like to be an elite athlete, after the show, head on over to the Toyota Sports Festival, and you can take home a gold medal of your own. It is amazing stories like Oksana's.
Journey on the final one is
okay, I'm not gonna lie here. I have no idea what this is, but it's pretty cool. There's no name anywhere on it. The touchpad don't work. Oh, now it does.
Okay, hold on.
Nope, no, it doesn't.
So me and this family right here, we get In-N-Out burger, we get some double
dough. Wow, look at that.
Fries, some chocolate shakes, and then what happens?
Then the micropaddle will drive itself down your
street. Practically a tow truck. You definitely put a nice camper on it.
Yeah, we all want that awesome, friendly robot.
Before we move over to the future, let's go go back to the past, shall we? At least I think it's the past.
We got our two players. All right, buddy, we're going to be player number one. Remind everybody.
The Toyota Land Cruiser. Maybe not. Maybe this is just made to look distressed. Those look like LED lights. I thought this was a vehicle like from the 40s or something. And it's not. Well, they did a good job disguising. Pretty cool though. All right, if you thought that Lectra Mechanica Solo was cool, then I got a car for you. I'm not gonna lie to you guys here. I don't think I would fit in this thing, but it sure does kind of look cool. It looks like it'd be a lot of fun to drive, at least. I believe this is the iRoad. Mostly made for cities, maybe large corporate parking lots, Disneyland tram. I don't know, you decide, but it's an electric vehicle. A little bigger and very futuristic is the Toyota LQ here. Straight out of your favorite sci-fi movie, except they're actually designing it. This looks like it was made specifically shipped over from Japan. Wow, really cool. And of course, Toyota's big push here at the auto show is mobility. Their mobility charities and some of their technologies they're working on regarding that, which is cool, of course. Here's the Nissan section of the auto show. All the Nissan cars, the latest cars from Nissan. I gotta admit, Nissan is probably one of the last car companies I may buy from. And it's not because they're a bad car company, it's just nothing they've made has really impressed me or caught my eye. Nissan Ariya? Let's see what this is about. Oh, because these are pre-production cars, concept cars, in other words, doors are locked. You can't get in and play around in it. Another thing all these automakers seem to be doing at this auto show is everybody seems to have their own game you can play. It's like they all got together and said, we're all going to have a trivia game show at each of our sections. The Nissan Rogue. I just love the LEDs in these cars. One thing I am kind of jealous about owning a Tesla Model 3 as opposed to the rest of you folks is Android Auto.
You need to keep tapping that screen every 5 or 6 seconds. Keep that game on.
I love Android Auto. I love Waze. And it's a pain in the rear end to get it on Tesla. It's not impossible. But it's annoying enough where I don't run Waze in my Tesla on my screen.
Four quick questions. Keep that game on screen always.
But yeah, nothing. There's the Nissan Frontier. Nothing Nissan makes particularly impresses me where I would even consider buying a Nissan. But they're still big and they still have a...
All right, finish registering. I'll try and stall for a couple more seconds.
They're still making an appearance.
I'll give you some tips.
At the auto show.
12 seconds for question number one.
There's a Nissan Z GT4. Every major automaker here has their own souped up race car. I'd love to see each of them go toe-to-toe with each other. That'd be a lot of fun. If every year the automakers just brought out their best race car and it was a competition, I don't know, maybe 100 laps, maybe an obstacle course a little bit, maybe a dirt road here. I don't know, what do you guys think? A little bit of ambience here at the auto show. Here's what it kind of looks like. This reminds me of something like, kind of like out of Epcot, like Innovations, or the innovations they had at Disneyland at the old Carousel of Progress building. All right, where are we headed next? Because there's a couple more auto makers to check out. Let's check out Honda. Honda's another one of those automakers I don't keep up with at all. They make decent stuff, but the only thing of a Honda I think I've ever bought was a generator. So I know their motors work. You can tell I'm not much of a car guy. One of the biggest reasons I'm a Tesla guy as opposed to any of the other competition in automotives is I do not like dealerships. And I guess on the podcast we'll talk a little more about why I don't like dealerships and some of my experiences in dealerships and how I've overcome dealers. Power of dreams. It's a Honda Pilot. And Honda, we know you have to drive for fun. What is the rain? We're in the desert. Is that a camera in the front? Sure is. Conquer the mountain to see. Interesting. And excellent, actually. You do need a camera on all sides of your vehicle these days, as far as insurance goes, and because what happens when you get in an accident? What's the first thing you're supposed to do? Not claim fault, even if you're at fault. Well, that's where dash cams and cameras come in. It's pretty easy for the insurance company to find out, hey, you're actually innocent, and the other guy is the one that hit you. So I wasn't going to take too much stock in Volkswagen, maybe walk through real quick, but this is the return of the Volkswagen VW bus, and as you can see, it's generating a lot of buzz for good reason. Speaking of buzz, it's not called the VW bus now, I guess they're going to call it the ID bus. Look at that V8 1200 horsepower motor. Okay, maybe it's got 200, I don't know. I'm not a car guy, but look how much people are having fun just getting into it. Just a gentle reminder. Now, I'm probably the farthest thing away from a hippie that you're gonna find, but even I recognize a cultural icon like a VW bus when I see one, and its remake. To be completely honest though, I'm not overly impressed with it. It's just, I guess it's kind of like a minivan, a large minivan. It's kind of what I would kind of put it as. All right, we're headed over to Lexus now. They make some nice luxury vehicles, don't they? Look at this rose colored bronze, rose-colored Lexus here. Lexus RX 500H. I do kind of like the blue-colored Lexus SUVs. I think they look pretty slick, personally. The NX 450H Plus.
Would you please care for the short for the NX plug-in?
It's not enough to just have a number on your model now. Now it's the NX 450H Plus. What are they gonna add after the plus, you guys think? And of course, it's a hybrid, a plug-in hybrid. Now this looks cool, I'm not gonna lie. But it's a 450E, I guess. That steering wheel. Look at that steering wheel. So did they steal this from Elon, or did Elon steal this from them? That's a trick question. There was actually a vehicle that that had a yoke steering wheel like that well before all these other cars did. Here's Genesis and their lineup. They make some interesting cars. Very, I guess they're the Cadillac of the modern age. Here's a Genesis electrified vehicle. I thought they were going to be a competitor with Tesla, but they never caught on as big. And I personally think that's because of the price, but also the Tesla supercharger network. They have a little bit of everything. They got SUVs, sports cars, sedans, and SUVs that kind of can double as a van, I guess. You know who loves getting in the vehicles the most? Well, not the adults, but the kids seem to like to hang out and sit in the vehicles and play, pretend drive. Here's the all-electric Silverado, and it sure does look beautiful, let me tell you. I think Elon and Tesla better hurry up with that Tesla truck if they're gonna keep up. But something Elon said a while ago kind of stuck with me. Anybody can build a electric vehicle or electric truck. That's easy. But making an electric truck you can afford is hard. Or it was something like that. But point proven. This Chevy Silverado is going to cost you a lot. I was hoping to find a price over here. It's going to cost you $80,000, $90,000, $100,000, and the Tesla truck is supposed to be coming out at about $40,000, $45,000. So that's the trick: make a high quality vehicle at a price people can afford. Here's a Chevy Equinox. I am loving the futuristic designs of a lot of these 2023 models.
The rear passenger legroom of 3 inches to make up for a very comfortable and convenient ride. Active noise cancellation is also standard.
I love what they're doing with the LEDs. I love the sleekness of these electric vehicles.
The tracks also have an impressive
really cool and look at that
features, starting with Chevy Safety Assist. If you're not familiar with that,
it's like people get into my car for the first time, they're going to have to learn how to get into your Chevy Equinox. Because they're not going to know how to, get the handle. One cool thing about coming to the auto show, if you like cars or considering buying a new car in the next few years, you get to see the models that are coming out in either 2 years from now, or you get to see the concept vehicles that are going to be the next vehicles you're going to be able to buy at the dealership. Case in point, here's the 2024 Chevy Silverado. I guess it's a subversion of the Chevy Silverado called the High Country. High Country Midnight Edition. And of course, no trip to Chevy section of an auto show would be complete without checking out the Corvette. Forget your leather bag if you decide to buy a Corvette. Wow, they are really works of art, aren't they? I'm not even a car guy, and this is just, wow. It's just impressive. Yellow, not your thing. No bumblebee, no worries. We got white right over here. Look at that. That could be you and your significant other. Stay in college, kids. A lot of the automakers have their company stores here where you can buy licensed merchandise. You want a Corvette watch, they got you covered. A wallet, a little light where you can work on it when it breaks down. There it is. What is that? Oh, ratchet straps, I guess, for the Silverados. Pretty cool. Keeping with the EV theme that all the automakers are going with, here is the Chevy Bolt EUV. I love how quiet these cars are. You guys can actually hear me now. And one of the doors is open too. And the window, and it just feels so peaceful and quiet in this thing. So here's a new EV company coming out called VinFast. Let's see. Oh, and they say here too, an EV that's actually coming soon. As in, we're not just generating media buzz with a concept car that'll never come out, that nobody can ever afford. VinFast. Yet another Tesla competitor. And here's one of their models. The VinFast VF8, it looks like. I definitely would like to get you guys some more screenshots of the inside, but every time I come up to a car, there's a kid in it. And I don't want to take a picture of a kid in a car. Parents might get kind of freaked out or something. I don't know. You don't know how they're gonna react. Look at that though. keeping with the Tesla theme of the folding handles. I think we got that kid out of the vehicle. Let's take a look. Looks like Tesla has some competition. They better innovate. It looks like they're only going to come out with one model. I stand corrected. Here's the VF7. That's the VF8. This is the VF7. So is this a VF6? It sure is. Here's their VF6. Looks like the screen's a little smaller on the VF6. Last but not least, from VinFast.
So first off, the first question I'd like to ask everybody, what do you think about the green?
I don't know if I'd like the green. But pretty cool. The more competition we get in the space, the cheaper those prices are gonna get. So I'm all for it. I'm all for more EV companies. And not all of them are gonna make it. Some are gonna fail. But really nice looking vehicles, huh? Here's a company you probably haven't heard of yet, Hyperion. And I'm standing next to their supercar, something straight out of the year 3000. And they plan on selling these around 2025. I mean, what is that? A competitor to the flux capacitor? Holy smokes, is this thing like wildly beyond supercar. That's exactly what it is. It's a spaceship, not a car. Hyperion must have got with some extraterrestrials and borrowed some of their designs. I wonder what they wanted in return. But wow. Not even Hollywood can come up with something as cool looking as this for their sci-fi movies. Here's Kia now. And Kia's always been kind of the butt of jokes for a couple decades now with their cheap Korean cars, the Kia Rio. But they've come a long, long way, have they? You guys think? Like when they first came out with their Niro, before I decided to go with Tesla, that was definitely a car I was considering. Now, in hindsight, I'm glad I went with the Tesla again, as I always harp on the supercharger network. But these displays and the Kias, they're really being innovative, and they're really kind of thinking ahead. This is stuff you see usually in luxury vehicles, unique stuff like that, instead of just a flat little screen mounted in the dashboard. The Kia Sportage. As I said, Kia has come a long way. They are making some really cool vehicles now. And it looks like they're putting that long rectangular screen in all their vehicles, all their latest vehicles and concept cars. I've never even heard of a Seltos. What is that, Greek? The refreshed 2024 Kia Seltos. Never heard of it. They even made a garage. I wish I had a garage like this. Look at this. Oh, the car, right, sorry. But seriously, wow. This is seriously something you'd usually see in a luxury vehicle. The Kia Telluride. And as always, if you want your Kia store merchandise, you can get them here. Really, from bags and notebooks to a robot dog sculpture. I wouldn't mind that coffee cup, I'm not gonna lie. But very cool. This is what I was going to get when I was considering buying an EV. I'm glad I got a Model 3, but the Niro is still a pretty cool vehicle.
Duffel bag from Kia. Make sure you register with one of our product specialists here today. Also, make sure you take a look at some of the new vehicles in our product lineup, including the EV6, which is...
And of course, Kia's not forgetting about the average Joe. They got all their sedans here on display. Here's the Kia Rio. They're, I believe, their cheapest car that you can buy. The Kia Forte.
Again, if you're interested in taking home that complimentary duffel bag from Kia, we have it in the bag. Just register
up. Kia K5.
We have Una up front taking down our some names, and we also have Steve here.
The Kia Stinger GT2 with a V6 engine. Neat interior with the suede. And I'm guessing this is a Soul. Again, I'm not a car guy, but I was correct. The Kia Soul. Here's another Kia Seltos. Interesting, it doesn't have that that wraparound dash screen. It's got the traditional.
I love how this, I mean, with the red too. Although these are really good. Like, I could easily do this.
Let's get a little look inside here. Here we go, here's that wraparound dash that I love. Again, it just amazes me how quiet it is in these newer vehicles. You know, cut out the mess from the traffic and the city of sounds. Sometimes you just want some peace and quiet after work before you head home, right? Or when you're trying to wake up in the morning. That's Kia. Here's Volvo. Straight out of Sweden, all right? Employees here at Volvo don't seem as active. They seem more sitting around, playing on the phones. I guess after a long day at the show, I'd probably be doing the same thing. Now we're getting into Mazda, specifically Galpin Mazda, which is a dealership here in SoCal. Not too many models, not too much buzz. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what the deal with Mazda is these days. It's more of a niche kind of car. They did roll out one of their classics, though. Take a look at this guy. Wow. Look how much smaller people were back in the old days, kids. Could you fit in there? Be pretty tight for me. Okay, here's Polestar, another major competitor with Tesla, making some high quality EVs. I wish I could get you guys a better look in there, but the reflections aren't gonna help. The Polestar 2. Pretty impressive. Now we got Lincoln. The Lincoln Aviator. Always with that wood trim, huh? It's like a classic car brought into the modern age. Very beautiful. How much do one of these cost? It's like, oh, this is gonna run you about $75,000 MSRP. Of course, you can negotiate the dealer down, maybe $100, $150, if you're really good. I'll tell you about my negotiating days on the podcast once we get there. Look at this classic. Completely restored. White wall tires. And of course, no seatbelts, just like the old days. Look at that tiny mirror. There's my GoPro 11. Here's a GMC Canyon. And I feel like GMC has kind of gone off the map a little bit. Although they are still big in the truck space. But here's the GMC section. Let's see what they got. Here's a GMC Sierra. And there's a Hummer. Interesting, they're gonna bring the Hummers back with EVs. Because Lord knows you can't afford the gas bill on the original Hummers unless you're part of the US government. Here's the new Hummers. In like a small stereo on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. In case you want to go camping and you don't want to listen to the birds and the owls and the nature, you want to blast music and tick off your campmates nearby. No more motor, at least not in the traditional sense. We've checked out most of the vehicles and their dealers, and here we are at the last one, Hyundai. Hyundai. Don't have United status to get into the United Club? Don't worry. If you own a Hyundai, you can get into the Hyundai Lounge. Really cool. It's nice to give back to their loyal customers like that. I don't own a Hyundai, so I can't get into the Hyundai Lounge. But I can only imagine what's in behind these walls. What luxuries. And five-star service and Michelin rated restaurant food is behind these walls. I kind of mistook this for a DeLorean at first. They are coming out with a newer DeLorean. I guess if they made Back to the Future in 2022, they would use this as the time machine. This is the Envision 74. Here's a Hyundai Nexo, the interior cabin. Look at that dash center console and all the buttons that are there now. It seems like everybody's doing the pull-out handles now. Something interesting Hyundai did is all their little showcase cars or their current lineup is all white. They should have brought a little color out. Hyundai Santa Fe. Again, here's Hyundai's test track. Nothing special, no shock test, no hills to climb. It's just a little mini racetrack, like you might see if you were racing go-karts. This caught my eye, though. Look at that. Hyundai Santa Cruz. Adventure is out there, folks. And you can get to it in the Hyundai Santa Cruz. At least that's what they're trying to say here. And just like all the other 4x4 outdoor vehicles, they got a whole lineup of accessories you can add. One of the last cars I want to show you guys at the Hyundai section is the Ioniq 5. They start off at $41,000.
Good evening and welcome to the Hyundai booth. We are excited to share with you the newest addition to our Ioniq EV brand, showcasing next generation.
Seems like that's a new thing that's going on. They're adding long rectangular screens on the dash.
Its streamliner silhouette is the top aerodynamics of any EV on the market, with a coefficient of drag of 0.22. Showcasing.
And you know what? I forgot all about Prius. But that's still a thing, right? They used to be so popular, it took, what was it, like 8 months? Backlogged, ordered. Because everybody wanted to own a Prius. They look pretty slick still. But with the advent of electric cars at the forefront, they've kind of they were popular for hybrids, weren't they? Everybody wanted to be seen. It's like that South Park episode. Everybody was smug because they owned a Prius. They're saving the environment, saving the world. And obviously Priuses are electric too now, but that's kind of what they've been known for, was hybrids. That's what I always thought of. When I think of a Prius, I always thought of hybrid. But now there's a lot of other electric cars that are kind of taking the forefront. And that's the LA Auto Show, folks. That's just about everything there is to see. A little racetrack they built. At first I thought these were automatic, but they're not. Someone's actually driving them. In fact, these people on the screens at another location are driving them. They got little cameras on there, so they're crashing them. They're trying to drive them from a remote location. Ouch. That's going to cause some paint damage.
That's lap time. Let me know.
Pretty cool. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of the One Day in SoCal vlog. I hope this complements the podcast, and I hope to do these for each podcast episode. If you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and check out the podcast, onedayinsocal.com, for the latest episodes, travelogue, social media links, videos, pictures, and more on everything there is to do here in Southern California. Thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for checking out the video, and we'll see you on the next one.